You're watching The Buck Stops Here. Welcome back. Ahead of Independence Day, Major Mukund Varadarajan was among those honoured with a gallantry award, the highest peacetime gallantry award, in fact, the Ashok Chakra, for his courage displayed in killing three terrorists in the Kashmir Valley. Major Mukund Varadarajan's case drew the headlines and the attention of the country when he was martyred in Jammu and Kashmir. In fact, the Air India pilot who flew back and were to carry back that body bag, that coffin to his parents, wrote a letter to them later saying, please count me as one of your sons. His martyrdom, his courage, his loss has really touched a chord, in fact, among so very many people here. And from Chennai today, on this day that the country has honoured their son with the highest peacetime gallantry award, we're joined by the parents of Major Mukund Varadarajan, Raghav Chari Varadarajan and Geeta Varadarajan. Mr. Varadarajan, I'd like to start with you. Words are never enough. No matter what I say, it will mean very little to parents who have lost their son. But what would you like to say to the country today and to Mukund's fellow men and women in the army on this day when he has been honoured with the Ashok Chakra?
No, actually, Colonel Rajeshwar, CO 44RR, called me this morning and informed that Mukund's hard work, sacrifice has been rewarded by awarding Ashok Chakra to him. They said they are all very 44RR is very proud of him because he was in this in their regiment. Though it's very difficult for us to digest the Mukund's absence, this has come as a we are a bit happy that his service has been recognized. Yes. His ambition is achieved. What he wanted to achieve, achieved. And the thing is, he is not here to enjoy the fruits of his hard work.
Yes. Geeta Varadarajan, as a mother, you know, you probably carry this every day inside your heart. Your son was just in his early 30s when he was martyred. You know, does the nation's recognition make it a little more possible to deal with the daily pain? I remember a mother of a soldier who'd been martyred in Kargil telling me, mothers die a little bit every day when they lose their children in this way.
Yes, actually, by seeing the youngsters who marched from our house in Tambaram to Besanagar, 150 students were carrying flag and they were marching. By seeing that, actually, they in the scorching sun, they were coming in the motorcycle. They were, by all seeing that, I thought that Mukund has done something very great. But we really lose him.
Yes, I can imagine. I can only begin to imagine. In fact, nobody can actually feel what both of you feel. Mr. Varadarajan, did you want your son to join the army?
Actually, when he asked me, I wanted to join Air Force. At the time, one of my cousins who was in the Air Force died. So my parents, they prevented me from joining a defense service. But I never thought my son would join the army. But right from his age, studying class 3, he wanted to join, serve in the army. So I thought it was only a child's, this thing. When he grows up, he may change. But he never changed. He had a group of friends who were like-minded. Two of them joined army, one Air Force, one police. So Mukund was very particular that he wanted to join army, especially infantry. So I said, okay, I never thought, many of my relations who were in the army, Air Force and the Navy, they have retired they retired well. So I never thought this should happen to my son. Even during his, after his short service commission, he asked me whether to go for a permanent commission. I said, okay. And my daughter-in-law said, Appa, he is asking you just for the sake of asking you. But he has decided to continue with the army. Yes. So I don't think I would have forced him or influenced him to serve in the army. It was his decision and ambition. And he has been rewarded. Though he is not with us, he has been rewarded. That sort of happiness is with me.
Yes. You must be very proud, parents, of course, and the whole country is proud of him. But let me ask you, Mr. Varadarajan, you know, families who are left behind to deal with the loss often have to be much braver. And I can see that courage. Both of you are so extraordinarily stoic in the way that you're even talking at this moment. Do you believe the Indian soldier gets the honor that he deserves, gets the recognition from society at large that he deserves? Or is it just lip service?
No, but that I know, after Mukund Samman's death, I've seen many of the youngsters who have completed chartered accountancy and IT professionals, they wanted to join army. They called me over phone, "Sir, I want your blessings. Mukund is like my brother. We want to join army and serve the army." We asked them, "You know the problems in the army. If you're in the infantry, you have to face the enemy." That, "No, sir, we want to be like him." So the thing is, after this this award given to him, that many youngsters would join. Even before that, no, they wanted to follow the footsteps of Mukund. So yes, influence, I don't know. Even the Facebook, I am getting many friends request. They consider him as his brother. They say he is still living with us.
Yes.
It's a great thing. No, I never expected such from the public.
Geeta Varadarajan, just a last thought from you tonight. It's of course especially difficult for Indu, Mukund's wife, their young daughter. What do you tell your granddaughter about her father?
Granddaughter, whenever she doesn't know what has happened to him, she whenever she talks about Mukund, she will tell that Mukund Varadarajan, that is my father. She used to tell like that. She is proud of her father, actually. And now she doesn't know what is going on at all. She always wanted to chat with him in Skype. He is asking a Hindu to connect to father to chat with him. In
how old is she today? How old is your granddaughter?
Three years old.
So too young to really comprehend the enormity of what's happened.
Ah.
Yes. Mr. Varadarajan,
yes.
last thoughts from you tonight. You know, what do you want to tell everybody watching this about your son, Mukund?
I never guided Mukund. He was on his own. And I've seen the youngsters of today, they decide, they take decisions. They want to become something, and they are achieving it. It's really wonderful. In those days, whatever my father said, I was following him. He said, "You go to bank, you join a bank." I joined a bank, like that. But these youngsters are, they know all the, they get all the information, and they themselves act in a very good way. It's a good thing for India. And actually,
yes.
Mukund, they think Mukund as an example.
Well, I think he is an example for so many young men and women. To both of you, Mr. Varadarajan and Geeta Varadarajan, we admire your courage and your calm in this moment of loss. And of course, just like you're proud of your son, the whole country is proud of him. Thank you so much for joining us on a day when your son has been honored with the highest peacetime gallantry award, the Ashok Chakra. We leave all our viewers tonight with a poem that was penned by Major Mukund Varadarajan's wife, Indu, for him. I think these words perhaps capture the loss and what families deal with when someone they love is gone.